Hello lads, it's TomLFC7 here and we are back with our Liverpool career mode, and this is the Champions League semi-final second leg against Real Madrid, away titanic battle between two European giants, and this presentation of the Bernabeu Stadium is absolutely lovely, like the players coming out of the tunnel. I really love this one, and we have drawn the first game 1-1. As you saw in the previous episode, Madrid have one away goal, but if we score two or more goals, then we can more than it would be enough to go through, in my opinion. But hopefully we won't concede that many goals, but it will be really hard. And because my virtual pro is injured, I play Eliaro Elia as a striker in this game. And he came to life in the second half, as you will see, but because of this I had to play Piet Roypa as a left winger, who is not a natural left winger, so it was really hard. But here Gerrard does an absolutely lovely through ball to Elia, and look at this chip! That is wonderful, and Suarez has the simple task of tapping it in into the open goal, and the Madrid players and the Casillas is absolutely gutted. Casillas was just walking behind the goal there after we scored. It was lovely scene, and we have that away, crucial away goal already. But here Madrid is no mugs because they almost immediately equalized through Higuain, and that was a lovely header. But we try and keep on attacking this time. And here Elia, my makeshift striker, has a great chance, but Casillas with a wonderful world-class save. I just watched the Chelsea-Aston Villa Barclays Asia Trophy final, and Torres came on after 60 minutes and he scored with his first touch. It was really surprising seeing him scoring, because after his 50 million move to Chelsea, he scored only one goal. So thanks for the 50 million pounds, you Chelsea rent boys. And we conceded a second goal by a ridiculously good Khedira goal, which was absolutely amazing, smashing goal. And here Elia combines with Gerrard, and he has a great chance to grab an equalizer. That was a lovely, lovely passing move. And Elia gets us into a position where we are through now at the moment with away goals. But we keep on attacking, and here Gerrard has a great shot, and the defender handles the ball, and it's a penalty. So Gerrard steps up, our captain fantastic, and Casillas dives the other way, and we wait for that, and we score with Gerrard, and it's amazing, amazing comeback now. We were trailing 2-1 by a fantastic Khedira goal, but we came back and we are leading now 3-2, and I make 3 substitutions, and Jesus Navas was a bit mad by the look of it there, that I substituted him. And we just keep on attacking. On Monday, Liverpool will play Vålerenga in our second to last pre-season friendly, and it will be really good to see some of the first team players play. And here Elia scores his second goal, and it was an absolutely great run with Suarez. He bamboozled the defense, and then Casillas shaved his shaved what am I talking about? I meant saved his shot. Oh, epic fail by me, guys. So Casillas saved his shot, but Elia had the simple task of tapping it in to the empty net. And here another passing move, as Madrid were on ultra attacking mode, so their defense was a bit exposed, and Elia gets his hat-trick, and we won 5-2 in the Bernabeu. And in the other semi-final, Barcelona have beaten Chelsea 2-0, sorry, after a 1-1 draw in the first leg, and we get more than 3 million pounds from this game. And after getting £3.2 million from the semi-finals of the Champions League, we are off now to fight for the league title against West Ham. We have a home game against West Ham United next, and both Manchester United and Chelsea are breathing down our necks in the league. Manchester United are trailing us by 1 point, I think, and Chelsea has 2 games in hand, so if they win those games, then they will be right behind us as well. So it was a really crucial game, but I made some substitutions and my changes to the team, because some of them were really tired, and Suarez almost scores a great opener here, but he shoots wide, and West Ham made us work really hard, and here Callison has a wonderful chance to score, but he has an awful, awful shot there. And here Elia gets on a great run, and he just runs and runs and runs and crosses in an absolutely beautiful peach of a cross to Suarez, who heads in to the net, and the goalkeeper and the defender couldn't prevent that. And that was just at the end of the first half, so we went into halftime 1-0, and the money from the Champions League will come really handy in the summer transfer window, because I am planning to sign some really, really good new players. I am planning to sign a left back instead of Coentrão, and hopefully I can sell Coentrão and get a major improvement on him, because he has a rating of 79, but there are many better left backs on FIFA in this career mode series. And here Suarez gets his second goal, and just in this last part of the season, Suarez is stepping up the plate, and he plays one of his best football, like in real life in the Copa America. He scores almost every game, and we need him to, because my virtual pro is injured. So as you can see here, Manchester United have drawn their game, so we are leading the United team by 3 points with 3 games left. And our next game is against Tottenham Hotspur away, and this is an epic, epic game, because this is the 36th Premier League game, and we are leading Manchester United by only 3 points, and if Chelsea win their game in hand, then they will be second place, 2 points behind us. So if we lose this game, then Chelsea could become champions. So it's vital, absolutely vital, to win this game. But I have to field my reserve starting 11, because we have the FA Cup final just after this game. So I was really nervous and a bit worried that my reserve 11 won't be very good, but I was proved wrong again, as like in the Sunderland game, where I played my reserve team and I scored 8 goals with them. So here Andy Carroll gets us off to a great start. It was a wonderful cross by N'Gog, and he plays really well in this last part of the season. And Carroll also stepped up his game, and here he almost scores his second goal. But we just keep on attacking. This first half was simply amazing. I couldn't believe it. I was all over Tottenham with this team, and Joe Cole goes around the defender wonderfully, and he slots it home, and we are already 2-0 up against Tottenham, who is a very, very hard team to beat. Last season we have only won here 2-1 by a 93rd minute Steven Gerrard late goal, and here N'Gog goes on a great run, identical to the first goal, and he puts in another beautiful cross to Carroll, and it's 3-0 inside 37 minutes. That's an unbelievable first half by this reserve starting 11. And I make 2 substitutions, bringing out on 2 very young 20-year-old players. And here Tottenham score a goal, but it was offside, so it didn't count. And I didn't have many chances in the second half. I just wanted to keep the 3-0 lead. As you can see here, I try to contain Van der Vaart, and he puts in a cross, but it was not very threatening. And our last game is the FA Cup final, and it's a surprising opposition, because Bolton Wanderers have knocked out Arsenal, so we play Bolton in the FA Cup final at the wonderful Wembley Stadium, and I love playing in this stadium. In the curtain raiser, in the first game of this second season, I have beaten Chelsea 7-1 in this stadium, and that that game will live long in my memory, at least, because that was one of the best games ever by me on FIFA, and I remember that new signing Suarez and Navas scored on their debuts. So Bolton is a very surprising team to play against in the FA Cup final, but I really like them. Since Owen Coyle took over at Bolton Wanderers, in real life they play a really good football. And here Elia passes to Gerrard, and he has a wonderful chance to take the lead. And Steven Gerrard is Mr. Liverpool. That's why he is called Captain Fantastic, because he doesn't miss those chances. He has one of the best shots in the game. And in real life, he is the most complete midfielder I have ever seen. Maybe only the likes of Zidane or Xavi can rival him. But here Bolton come back in the 43rd minute by Kevin Davies. So it's a really close game. And to be honest, I expected a close game against Bolton, because in both league games we have drawn 1-1 against them at home, and we have beaten them 4-1 away. So at home they really gave me a really hard game. And look at this, Suarez gets on a great run, and Jaskalainen comes out, and that is what I call a very, very classy finish. Suarez is just becoming an even better and better and better player game by game, and I'm starting to love him more and more and more as each game passes by. He's just absolutely fantastic, despite his this shot, which was not the best, but that chipped goal was absolutely lovely. And I loved how the defender tried to burst his lungs and get back, but he couldn't. And here Joe Cole gets on a great run, and he has a good shot on him, but Jaskalainen is a good keeper, so he saves these shots. And Lucas has a pop from distance, why not? We tried to score a very great goal. And here they bring up the goalkeeper to the corner, because it's the 93rd minute. And here Elia is away, and he surely must score, because it's an open goal, but the referee blows his whistle. Oh my goodness, I hate when that happens. I absolutely hate it. I could have scored the third one with Elia, but never mind, it doesn't matter really, because we have won the FA Cup in the second year running, and we have fulfilled one part of the board's objective, which is win the domestic cup. The other part, of course, is win the league title, and we have two more games to go to win the league title. And here you can see my team celebrating, and hope you enjoyed this episode. It was really, really fun playing with this team, and I'm really, really looking forward to the summer transfer window now, because we will have some really good money to spend. So stay tuned for the next episode, and please give this video a like if you enjoyed. See you later, bye.